Hello there, folks, and welcome to the Munch. And this particular video is basically all the episodes that were on the original channel. For those who don't know, the Munch was actually an invention on my previous channel, Terrellian Productions, which I brought over to this new channel just solely as the sole premise of the channel. Either way, these are 9 of the original episodes, and I hope you guys enjoy. Hello there, and welcome to The Munch, a brand new show where we try different sorts of snacks every single week, either which I haven't had in a while, or I've never tried before at all. Today, the first thing I'm trying is a childhood favourite of mine. It is a Kit Kat by Nestle. Just to see how this matches up to my memory, it is two biscuits which are actually covered in chocolate, with Kit Kat actually written on it. You may not be able to see because of my camera. Ah, there you go. So let's try this, see how it matches up. So basically the traditional way is to snap it in half, and then... it's a lot better than I remember it being. And next we're going to try a breakaway bar. I've never had one of these before. Breakaway original, in fact, by Nestle. So we take it out of the yellow packaging. And we can see it's got kind of a wooden floor design to the chocolate bar there. So without further ado, this is a show called The Munch, so let's give it a try. Not bad. Not that bad. As you can see, the inside is mainly a traditional biscuit covered in a nice chocolate. It's probably actually better than the Kit Kat, to be honest. And also, we got a bar which I didn't hear about either till earlier this week. It's a Mr. Choc Cocos and Choco Bar. It's like a Milky Way with coconuts, essentially. So, basically a bounty. I'm going to try this since I've never tried one before. So, here we go. The taste of it, generally, it's not as strong coconutty as a bounty bar, but it's definitely not too little either. So last but not least, let's get into our final thing we're trying. Today we have Snacktastic Prawn Cocktail Crisps. And these are the basic Walker's ripoff snack oil crisps. I'll try these, see what they're like. I'm hoping it's not like, I'm wondering if it's an overwhelming taste or not. I'll try it now. Not bad. The prawn cocktail taste is very there. It's like very strong in a way. There's a very salty taste to this as well, like on top of that. Yeah, it's a lot stronger than Walker's crisps or Lay's crisps, if you will. Right guys, and that was the first episode of The Munch. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like by there. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe below here. And if you'd like to leave a request for what I should try next, then please leave it in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I hope to do one again soon. Right, have a nice day. Hello there, and welcome to The Munch. And this episode, we're doing Polish snacks. That's right, we're doing snacks from Poland this time around. So without further ado, let's start. The first one we have a muesli snack for a change, and this is a tiger ski bar. Yes, apparently this is a muesli bar, and hopefully it's going to be pretty nice. I heard these are actually supposed to be good. And as you can see in it, if anyone here is a fan of tracker bars or oat bars, as you can see, the inside of it is your typical muesli and fruit mix, as well as bits of chocolate as well. So without further ado, let's have a try of a tiger ski bar. It's pretty nice. I'd recommend it for something like breakfast though. Gonna have that midday. The next thing we're gonna look at this episode is a marzipan bar. Yes, this bar. As you can see, it's a very nice, pretty plain foil design for the actual bar wrapper. Let's take a look at what the bar looks like itself. As you can see, the bar is a pretty small, pretty bland kind of looks like an after eight kind of thing. But as you can see, just by its little size, that is definitely based for the budget Polish chocolate market. Without further ado, let's have a try of the Marzipan bar. That is really nice. I was really not expecting that taste. Inside of it is actually, it's actually cake. That is very goddamn nice. I will probably go back and buy some more of those, actually. And for the next item, we have ourselves a Lubacy cake. This is called Barnaby in the UK. We've only just got this. And as you can see, it is a strawberry flavored cake bar. And as you can see, like, it's a very running cake theme in this episode by accident. And it's actually made of soft, squishy cake. That's the thing about these kind of things, though, is you don't know where to quite start. So I'm just going to go in for the side. The cake's nice, so I'm not really keen on the strawberry inside, though. As you can see, the inside of it actually has syrups and jams inside of it as well as a lovely cake center. And last but not least, we're going to wash it down with a bottle of Timbark. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Apple and peach flavored drink. It's got a really weird bottle top opener to it. It's one of these weird like ring pull things where you pull it upwards and then you pull it across. And there you go, it's open. That's a joy. So it has a very nice apple juice taste to it with a peach aftertaste. I would like to say that is very nice. I'm probably going to buy a lot more of these in the future. And that all but wraps up this episode. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and a comment below. And if you'd like to see more of my channel, be sure to subscribe. More Polish snacks are coming soon, as well as any other international snacks you'd like me to try. I would like to say goodbye and have a nice day. Hello there, and welcome to the Munch. And this episode, we're doing Polish snacks, episode 2. And that's right, this time we're looking at even more Polish snacks due to a massive demand to have another episode. And the first one we have today is a Powertech toffee bar. As I am not exactly sure, I've never seen these before, and I hope this actually tastes really nice. As you can see, it is a segmented bar with this really weird, like, angular line pattern to it. Either way, let's have a try. The traditional way to eat it is like this. Oh, it's more caramelly than toffee inside, but let's have another try. That's alright, but that's... Yeah, the toffee's okay, the chocolate is not very nice at all. Like, I would not recommend this. I'm sorry, guys, I just wouldn't. And the next item we have today is a 7 Butts. I think that's how you pronounce it. It's another oat bar, like the last episode. And this one appears to be a peach flavor too. I see it's fairly simple with the grains on top and a yogurty bit on the bottom. Just like most cereal bars. So without further ado, let's have a try. Yeah, you can taste more of the grain than you can the actual peach in it. But it's still pretty nice regardless. It is a very nice breakfast snack if I would have to recommend it for anything in the day. And the next item we'll look at today is a Nestle Princessa Zebra bar. These are not available in the UK, I really wish they were. I've tried this before, I liked it, but I'm going to give some impressions for you guys. And you can see, very popular in Poland are the very, like, wafer snacks. Like, wafer snacks like this are very, very popular in Poland. There's countless bars like it. So without further ado, enough of my yammering, I might as well try it. I will have to say I really like these, and the mix of the biscuit and the actual cream is very, very well done. Like, it's very well evenly balanced. Like, you can't overtaste one without tasting the other, so it's actually props to Nestle for that one. And the final item we have for today's show is a Maciek bar. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. And it looks like a simple caramelly bar, but we'll take a look further in detail inside of it. And like the bar earlier, it is segmented and it also has engraving on it. This time it would have the the, I think it's pronounced Varvel, chocolate company on it. So without further ado, let's finally give this a try. That's really not very nice. Like, it has the kind of thing of, it's the same with the problem with the one earlier, is the chocolate's not very nice, but on top of that, the filling is not very nice either. It's got this caramel filling to it, and it's honestly not good. I would not recommend it to anybody. And that about wraps up this episode. If you guys enjoyed, please leave a like and a comment below, and also please subscribe to this channel if you'd like to see more. I'd like to thank you guys for watching, and have a nice day. Hello there, and welcome to The Munch. In this episode we cover movie snacks. And the first item we have today is Haribo Minions Edition. Available during the release date of the actual Minions movie itself. And they released lots of promotional items. This is actually one of them. So, without further ado, let's have a try. As you can see by some of the packaging as well, it's banana and ice cream flavor, allegedly. But it does say something different on the back for the amount of flavors available. So, let's have a random two and let's see how they taste. I really like those. They taste like regular Haribo, except they have more of a vanilla-y kick to it due to the alleged ice cream flavored foam on the back of the actual Minion sweets themselves. Either way, I like these. I'll probably finish these off later, actually. And next we have a special item, as I didn't know it actually existed. Ladies and gentlemen, from Ghostbusters, Stay Puft Mini Marshmallows. And the reason that these are actually special is due to the fact that I thought these were just a movie-based brand and nothing else. The only place I can really see the Ghostbusters logo is really on the back and actually on the front a little bit here. Preferably you want these with ice cream or a nice cup of coffee or hot chocolate. Either way, let's dig in. They pretty much taste like every marshmallow I've pretty much ever had. In other words, nothing special. And the third and final item we have today, from the creators of Hot Tamales and Mike and Ike's, two things I really like, we have Warcraft Battle Blend. Tying in with the movie, actually, I have not seen the movie yet. I've not heard great things about it. But I just hope these might be better than the actual movie itself. As you can see here, these are actually, they look quite similar to Mike and Ike's and Hot Tamales. But we're going to try both the ones individually, just in case they taste differently. First of all, let's put in some blue ones. They taste quite fruity, but they don't taste as sweet as Mike and Ike's, which is really good to me. Though they do have a bit of a hot kick to them. And finally, we'll hear the red ones. With the red ones you can really taste the cinnamon. And that pretty much wraps everything up. If you enjoyed, please leave a like and a comment, and subscribe if you'd like to see more from this channel. And have a nice day! Hello there, welcome to The Munch, and this episode is Hungarian Snacks. And the first thing we have for you today is, we have you from Sturma, we have a Malnas Koka. This appears to be a small chocolate, and I shall have a try of it. As you can see by the inside of it, it actually has the Sturma logo actually on the actual chocolate itself. But either way, let's have a try of it, shall we? Can't really put my hand on the taste, really. I don't know what it tastes like, but it's not very nice. I'm sorry. If anybody watching this likes this, then I'm sorry. And the next item we have for you today, we have a Tish Chocolata. What looks like a camel bar. Again, I've never seen this before, so I shall give it a try as soon as I've opened it up. On the inside, it's actually segmented, like most... like small chocolate bars, but either way, let's have a try of it. That's not bad and it's not good. It's kind of like in the middle. It's very bland chocolate. I apologize, it's just really bland. The next item we have for you today, we have for you a Tilly strawberry chocolate bar. That's right, strawberry chocolate. I've never had strawberry chocolate in general, let alone a Hungarian or foreign chocolate for that matter. So let's just open it up here. And as you can see, it's actually segmented in the middle again, and you can actually see it's actually inside of the chocolate is the strawberry. So let's have a try. Not that nice. I'm sorry, it's just really bland. Like, the strawberry is barely tasteable, the chocolate's barely tasteable. I'm sorry, I just won't recommend Tilly to anybody. I'm sorry. And last but not least, we have ourselves today, we have ourselves a Bocky bar. And according to this, this is actually a white chocolate with coffee. So without further ado, let's have a try as soon as we've opened it up. By the way, very unusual color of chocolate we have here. It's kind of like the same as a very milky espresso. So let's have a try. Oh, blimey, you can taste the espresso straight away. Very, very coffee flavor to it. I'm personally not a fan of coffee, but I'll recommend this for anybody who likes coffee. And that's all we have for today, folks. If you enjoyed the episode, please leave a like and a comment below, and subscribe if you'd like to see more from this channel. And have a nice day. Hello there, and welcome to the Munch. And this week's episode, you're probably wondering to yourself, hey, why is Old Glory behind you? Well, Old Glory here is behind me because this episode we're doing American snacks. And the first one we have for you today, we have ourselves some Applehead. Now, I have never tried these before. I do not know what exactly these are. So, here we go. So, without further ado, let's give them a try. I will admit they're not quite my cup of tea, but they do remind me of Skittles a little bit. And the next thing we have today, we have ourselves a Milky Way French vanilla and caramel bar. We don't get these over in the UK, we just get regular old Milky Ways. All right, then let's give this a try. As you can see by the inside, it's the exact same as the Milky Ways over in the UK. But this one in flavor actually tastes a lot better in a way. Really wish we had a lot more of these over here. And the next item we have today for you, the third item, is a payday bar. We do not get these in the UK at all, so I'm really looking forward to trying this. And as you can see, it's kind of inside of it. It's got peanuts and caramel all holding this one thing together on the one caramel stick. Without further ado, let's enjoy. I will admit that it is quite tough to bite into, like due to the fact that the nuts are actually quite, still quite hard on this. But the chewy caramel in the center, it's like the perfect mix. Like, it's very salty, it's very chewy, I like it. And the next item we have today, like I've been looking forward to trying solely because we had these in the UK 5 years ago, and they've only just made mainstream store shelves. Ladies and gentlemen, we got ourselves some Cheetos Crunchy. On further inspection, I will have to admit they do look like knickknacks, which is a crisps we do get over here in Britain. But like, without further ado, let's have a try. I will have to admit this does make up live up to its name of crunchy, but I wouldn't recommend, though. They are quite bland. Like, if they had a bit more flavoring, sure, but they're just really bland. And if you enjoyed the episode, please be sure to like and comment below, and subscribe if you'd like to see more from this channel. And have a nice day. Hello there, welcome to the Munch. And this week's episode, we got ourselves a brand new setting, and also, it's a second episode of American Snacks! At first, we have a small Tootsie Roll. I've never had these, and so I'm looking forward to actually enjoying this one. As I can see, it's actually chocolate on the inside, but it's actually got this like really gooey, stretchy thing to it. So I'm essentially going to try it right now. That's very chewy. You could taste the chocolate inside it straight away, and also it's very strong chocolatey taste. It's very nice, and I will recommend it to anybody I can. And the next item we have for you today is actually something called a York, or a Yonk, depending how you're reading it. And yes, it appears to be a small chocolate little thing, but let's have a try of it, shall we? Oh, that's nice. We get similar things to this over here called After Eights, but they're a lot thinner than this, and also there's a lot of them in big packs. Like, this is literally just as nice as an After Eight. I think I'll have a lot more of these in the future. And the next item we have for you today, we have ourselves some Airheads watermelon flavor. So, from what my information, this is like a Vimto bar. So, as you can see already, it's actually very sticky and it looks like Gumby. Honestly, doesn't that look like Gumby? But yeah, it's very soft, very squishy texture to it. It has this really floppy form to it. So let's have a try anyway, since it is food after all. I don't really like that. It's not enough of a strong enough taste for me to enjoy it. Like, anybody watching this video enjoys them, you're free to. But it's not for me. And the next item we have for you today is actually something called Flavor Fusions. This is by the same company that made the Applehead product that I showed in the last video. And let's just open this up and see what it's like. Apparently it's supposed to be two flavors mixed into one bean, so then the actual flavors combine. Just open this up here, and as you can see, they're small, kind of like small jelly bean kind of things, but either way, let's have a try of them. I really rate those. Like, if you're used to jelly beans and you want a bit more variety to them, I would recommend getting these. And for 25 cents, I would say they're well worth the price. And speaking of the Lemonhead products, ladies and gentlemen, I've got for you today Cherryhead. Another product like Applehead from the last episode, and it probably has the exact same texture and stuff. Probably got a different flavor to it. Dip it out here, and as you can see, they're just cherry drops. Without further ado, let's have a try of them. That is the strongest taste of cherry in anything I've ever tasted, and I've had a Black Forest Gatto, I've had Relentless Cherry, I've had Cherryade. And this thing from the United States is the cherriest thing I've ever had. I would recommend this if anyone likes cherries. And from the famous E.T. movie, I should have done this in the last episode. Ladies and gentlemen, Reese's Pieces. Of course, if you want to know the backstory, apparently Skittles were going to be the official candy for the E.T. movie, but they pulled out for some reason, so Reese's Pieces took over. And then, thanks to that, E.T. was able to phone home. So we just put these out here. I've never had these. They kind of look a little bit like Smarties. Kind of a little bit. But either way, I've never had these before, despite them being available in the UK. So without further ado, let's have a try of them. Those are really nice. They have a peanut butter back taste to them, since they're made with peanut butter, as it says on the bottom of the packet below there. Yeah, I really like that. I really should buy more packets of those. And last but not least, we're going to wash it all down with a can of Hawaiian Punch. Of course, not available in the UK, and it's quite hard to get a hold of. But when certain stores do have it in stock, I'm buying the whole crate, usually. So we'll just open this up, and cheers. That's pretty nice. It's kind of like water with a back taste. I like it, I do. It's not It's not fizzy, it's not bland, it's pretty nice, it is. And that's all we have for today's episode. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and a comment below, and be sure to subscribe if you'd like to see more from my channel. And have a nice day. Hello guys, and welcome to The Munch. And this episode, I've got my producer here, Matthew Orion here, and we're doing American snacks for a third time.
America.
And the first thing we're going to try today, folks, we're going to try some pretzel M&Ms.
Ew.
These are not available over here in the UK. So without further ado, I'll just open these up here and we'll just share them.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll just try them as well.
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Do you think they're salty enough like pretzels or?
No, they're too sweet.
Or should we just say, yes, not that salty, I can just taste it straight away. Just salt and sugars won't really mix unless it's a cake.
Yeah, they're okay. It's just nothing special about them. They just taste like, you know, chocolate-coated pretzels, really.
And the next item we have for you today, folks, we got ourselves some Nutter Butter Bites. Now, I've already had these, and I like these. I had them off camera, so I'm gonna let Matthew here have a try of them.
Okay.
As you see, folks, it's very nice, like, kind of a biscuity type of thing, so without further ado, have a try.
Okay. It tastes quite nice, actually.
I knew you'd like them. Yes, folks, these are available in a place called America Andy in Cardiff. I hope you guys check it out. It's a very great place, and that's well worth...
Yes, that's a good place, that is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the next thing we have today, folks, we have the American version of Chew-Its. We have ourselves some Now and Laters. And these are the banana flavor, as you can tell by the yellow packaging. Yeah. You're going to have one. We're both going to try it at the same time, since we've both not tried this, and it's very hard to get into. I'll edit this crap out later. Well, folks, it's finally open, and bloody hell, that is yellow.
Yeah.
Either way, let's have a try.
That's just exactly how I expected it to be.
Tastes like bananas.
It tastes like bubble gum.
Yeah, like, it does taste like flavored gum, despite it being an actual chewy snack.
Yeah, it does taste like flavored gum.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've enjoyed the video. Please leave a like and a comment if you did, and have a nice day.
See you in the future.
Hello there, and welcome to The Munch, and this is our 60th Watcher special. I'd like to thank you guys for tuning in, and also we hit 30,000 views in this week as well. And I have a guest star with me today. I have with me my producer, Matthew Orion.
Hi!
And today we're going to be trying this, which we suspiciously got a package in the mail. Ladies and gentlemen, we actually got ourselves a bomb in the mail. So, without further ado, these are actually sex bomb jelly beans. They're supposed to be really hot. We're going to try them and show our reactions to it. As soon as I get this open, we just pour it out, and there's a bag of really evil looking monstrosities in here.
They look more like rubies, to be honest.
And we have ourselves, ladies and gentlemen, these are actually really red looking. They're like the hot tamales or anything of that nature. I have no idea how they taste, but they are already hot to touch. What are your expectations of this?
Burning eyes, burning mouth, dehydration, and something that quite hot. That's what I'm expecting.
Sounds like a weekend in Bristol. Okay, I got mine in my hand. Now you have a bit. So these are the sex bomb jelly beans. Let's have a try. Oh god. Oh god.
Ow.
Oh.
Ow.
Oh my god. Oh. Oh. Oh my god, thank goodness. Oh. Oh good, folks. Oh good. Oh.
Tastes a bit sweet.
Oh, go, go, go. Oh god, that's awful. Oh good.
Yeah, it's a bit burning.
It's attacking my ears. Oh. Oh.
Oh god. Get the coke over.
Get the coke. Get the coke.
No. You bastard, get over here. Oh. Oh. Oh, I'm still burnt.
Yeah, it's hot.
Oh. Oh, folks, that's not nice.
Yeah.
You did this to me. You did this. You can see my tongue. Put your tongue in the camera. Oh, that hurts. If you enjoyed the video, folks, leave a like and a comment below. And subscribe if you'd like to see more.
Okay.
2000 and we'll do the ghost chili. Sort it. Alright. Thank you for tuning in, folks. Have a good day.
Have a good day.